Hello and welcome to Anatomy of Marriage, Marriage Mornings. I'm your host, Melanie Studley.
Good morning, my name is Seth Studley. I'm a licensed marriage and family therapist, and today is day 78 of the Infinity Day Marriage Challenge, Marriage Morning.
If you're new here, welcome. We have over 100 episodes on all sorts of different topics. This is our Marriage Morning, and it's a very specific format, but we have an entire season one that's highly produced with music on all sorts of topics. Go check those things out, but this is Marriage Mornings.
Yes, and today, our show, like always, for the last couple of days, is brought to you by the Ultimate Intimacy app. It's an awesome app. It'll help you get closer to your spouse. I'm working on it, and partly that's what today's episode is about. So go check it out, Ultimate Intimacy app. Thank you for that. And today's episode is called It Takes Work. But before we do that, we do four things every single time. What are those, Melanie?
We do a prayer, a past gratitude, future hope, and goals. And we encourage you guys to do all of this stuff with us. Do these with your partner. Ask your partner the questions that we ask to each other and do it together. So let's dive right in. Do you want to pray or do you want me to
go for it?
Dear Lord, thank you so much for all of our gifts. Thank you for our blessings. Thank you for the work that we've done to make our marriage good. I pray that our show is an encouragement for couples to do the same in their life and that they can just join this journey with us and we can all be happy together. Amen.
Amen. All right. My past gratitude is I am thankful that you don't shy away from hard stuff. I, on the Enneagram, am a peacemaker. I don't like conflict unless it really comes down to it. And you don't care about it and you dive back into it because you point out conflict in hopes of making things better. Mm-hmm. You're not conflict seeking, you're conflict.
I'm solution seeking.
Solution seeking. So thank you for that. It absolutely sucks sometimes because it makes stuff hard, but it makes it better in the long run. So thank you for that.
You're welcome. I forgot to write a thing down today. Thank you for just being thank you for being a really, really fun dad. I know I've mentioned this before, but like, the way that you will go play soccer with the kids, you'll play card games, you'll paint your nails with Hattie, you'll do whatever to show the kids that you love them and that you're actively a part of their relationship. And I just really, really appreciate that.
Yeah.
Like you make time for them and let them know in a good way. So thank you for that.
Yeah.
What is it?
What's up, Brad? What's up,
Goal? Hope. Our future hope. I hope that today is good. I've got a ton of stuff going on and I hope that things go well. Mm-hmm. What's your hope?
I have meetings at work and clinical notes to do, but I'm coming home early. I don't know if I told you that. So I hope to hang out and get stuff done because I'm working tomorrow. So I hope to do stuff early today, home with you.
Cool. My goal is to get a bunch of work done, is to get very specific work done. So I'm excited for that.
Yeah, that's my goal too, just to be present. Mm-hmm. And so the goal today, or the title today is It Takes Work. And this was out of a conversation / late night conversation we had last night because Melanie is willing to bring up hard stuff. And I have a couple of bullet points that I want to talk about. Anything worth having, what are you smiling at?
People waving.
Oh, hey. anything worth having is worth working for. And I think about, you know, when you've set a goal and you work towards it, getting whatever that was is much more rewarding than just having it handed to you. We see this with like lottery winners and stuff like that. And it's always more rewarding because you set a goal, you do work, you sacrifice, and then you have it. And it's worth holding on to, right?
Keep talking. I'm going to fix the curtains. Keep talking.
Sure. You don't take it for granted. And I think that, hold on, now you're...
Sorry.
You messed my thing. I'm saying this because marriage takes work and everybody knows like, oh yeah, marriage takes work. We know that, blah, blah. But it takes work in the sense of you have to be willing to see your own stuff and not be mad at the person pointing that out. Mm-hmm. Like an example, I can't be mad at you for pointing something out. And last night we talked about emotional availability. Mm-hmm. And just like a couple of nights ago, we were talking about you don't know how to apologize. Mm-hmm. What did you do? You were solution focused and you went and you Googled it, right? So this morning, based on the conversation we had last night, I Googled emotional availability because this comes from family of origin stuff and it's just not something that I learned. Like emotional availability, I can be emotional for other people that I don't know, clients, distant friends or whatever. It's super easy and I'm all over it. But when it comes to like real kind of 100% all in stuff, it makes me really uncomfortable.
Well, when you don't have emotional availability for your close relationships, is the way I would say it. Mm-hmm. You're much more emotionally available if it's not like a long-term thing.
Right. Or it can be long-term, but kind of off and on, I guess, if that makes sense.
I don't know what that means, but sure.
So I Googled, you know, basically emotional availability, and I wanted to talk about, like, okay, what does that mean? Am I just going to read it and go, oh, yeah, I'm not this, I'm not that. Okay, well, that sucks for not for me, because I'm comfortable in it. It sucks for you and, like, kids and stuff, and that's not how I want to be. So just like you had to learn to, what does an active apology look like? Mm-hmm. The feeling behind it, the kind of connection in the moment. So what does, I'm asking myself, what does emotional availability mm-hmm. look like for me towards you? Because basically it's about our relationship and mm-hmm. of course then our kids' relationship. So do you have any thoughts on that?
Well, I don't know exactly what you're saying. I feel mm-hmm. like it's a little all over the place, because the point of today was it takes work. Well, so I want to tie that back around.
Right. It takes work. And I guess I'm just using my own narrative. It's like, it's going to take work for me, and it's going to take work for you to understand apologies and stuff like that. And I have to dive into emotional availability. So I was like Googling books all morning, this morning, looking up stuff. What does it mean? What are some interventions? What are some tips on that? And that is the work part. And then I also think about like our own work ethic. Like we were talking about this mm-hmm. a couple of days ago. Like we want certain things, and we wake up at 5, right? And I've already ran 2 miles, done a full workout, and we're producing a show mm-hmm. all before like 7:30 a.m. Mm-hmm. And it takes work, but it's worth it, right?
Yeah. It makes me think of the quote I heard Tony Robbins say one time mm-hmm. that if you're just given something and you didn't have to work for it, you actually almost can't value it. That doesn't mean you can't like it, mm-hmm. you can't think it's fun, but you don't value the things that are just given to you. And so when we say that it takes work, we don't mean, oh, it's crappy and it's hard and it's going to be like, you're going to get your hands dirty and blah. Like mm-hmm. we don't mean it in a negative, I think there's a lot of negative connotation with things being hard
right.
or taking work. But we're saying that that doing the hard work of creating the marriage that you want and creating the version of yourself mm-hmm. that you want, because that takes work, is so incredibly rewarding.
Right.
And sometimes it takes the self-awareness, the relational
awareness. Not sometimes. Oh, it starts with that, I believe.
It's like you popped my balloon. I went, oh, yeah.
Sorry.
I didn't mean to do that sound, but, mm-hmm. but so it takes that self-awareness, the relational awareness for you to go, wait, I'm not doing this to the level I want to do it. I'm not, like, the game that I'm playing is not the game I know that I could play.
Right.
So how do I step into that with a, like, I'll put my hard hat on, I'll put my work boots on, mm-hmm. I'll put my coveralls on, which I love coveralls and overalls.
Right.
Like real ones. And you say, I'm going to do the hard work that it takes to right. make this thing happen. And then once you do that hard work, like I said the other day, mm-hmm. I appreciate our marriage because you and I together mm-hmm. have worked so hard right. to make it good.
Right. And that looks different. Brad, what's up, Brad? It says each couple's work in the marriage is different.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, for
so
sure.
So my work is emotional availability and how I can mm-hmm. identify that, work on that, and change that. Her work is...
not being terrible.
Well, no. Understanding apologies and how that works and being emotionally present there and not uber focused
relating
on other
emotionally
work stuff,
is
right?
my
so,
problem.
Absolutely. Thanks, Brad. What's up, Paul? Good luck on the 75 days thing. kill it, brother. Yes, it takes work and it looks different. And I've also noticed this. It doesn't just like take work. Like you don't go to work one day and go, it took work.
That's
I'm
done.
I'm done. No.
You go every day.
It's like with the new spring season and stuff with us, we're like having conversations that we haven't had before. And some of them are kind of hard and crappy, but it takes work.
All of them yes. are fruitful and all of them are things
yes.
that... it takes work to do, but they will have a good payoff in the end. So thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Yep.
Please go out and check the Ultimate Intimacy app. Go to ultimateintimacy.com. We're going to be talking about that tomorrow for Sexy Saturday.
And we're going to do the work it takes to use the thing. So
that's exactly
be
right. We're going to do sex work. I'm just kidding. Anyway, thank you so much. Please rate and review the podcast if you're enjoying what we're doing. And please, please, please share it with your friends. That helps
right.
us out tremendously. Have an amazing day. Do the work that it takes. Do your marriage
yes.
mornings. We love you.
You All got right. it. Later.